हेलो फ्रेंड्स, माय सेल्फ डॉक्टर वी एन देशमुख, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फार्माकोग्नोसी, सुधाकर इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ फार्मसी पुसद। टुडे वी विल लर्न अबाउट होलाटाइल ऑयल्स, द ड्रग्स कंटेनिंग द होलाटाइल ऑयल्स। दीज होलाटाइल ऑयल्स दे आर ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज the essential oils or aromatic oils. They are called as the volatile oil because at room temperature they evaporate. They have a less boiling point and at room temperature they evaporate, so they are called as the volatile oils. They are called as the essential oils because it forms the essence for that particular plant and it become the characteristic for that particular plant, so it is also called as the essential oil. They are also called as the aromatic oil because they give a particular characteristic aroma by which they can be used as an flavoring agent. So the volatile oil, essential oil, aromatic oils, they are the one and same thing. These volatile oils, they are obtained from plant source as well as animal source. Maximum amount is obtained from the plant source. They are present in any morphological characteristic such as the stem, root, bark, fruit, flower, seed, as well as they may be present in whole plant. They are also present in wood, for example sandalwood oil. In animals they are also present, for example the kasturi, which is present in the kasturi brook. So they are obtained from plant source as well as from the animal source, and these volatile oils or the essential oils or the aromatic oils, they are used in the pharmaceutical industries, in food industries, in cosmetic industries, in beverages. They are used therapeutically for the treatment of different diseases and disorders. The learning objective of this topic, you have to study the introduction to volatile oil, properties of volatile oil, extraction of volatile oil, how the extraction is carried out, classification of volatile oils, uses of volatile oil, terpeneless volatile oil, which is preferred nowadays by a sophisticated cosmetic industries, chemical test for the identification of the volatile oil, and the storage of volatile oil. So first of all, we will learn about the introduction part of the volatile oil. Basically, the volatile oil, they are the terpenoids. The term terpene represent the hydrocarbons, that is C5H8 link, which the terpenoids contain, that is, it is an isoprenoid unit, or it consists of the isoprenoid unit, and it is biosynthesized through the isoprenoid unit in the plants. While terpenoids include the hydrocarbons as well as their oxygenated derivatives, and in these terpenoids the hydrocarbons as well as their oxygenated derivatives are included. Terpenes and terpenoids are found in all volatile oils of the plant or animal origin. So these terpenes or terpenoids, they are found in all the types of the volatile oil, either it may be obtained from the plant source or animal source. So the volatile oils, what are the volatile oils? The volatile oil are the odorous volatile principles of the plant and animal source are known as volatile oil. So these are the odorous principle. It will give a particular aroma, it will give a particular odor. They are volatile in nature, having a low boiling point, so they get evaporated at room temperature, and they are obtained from both plant as well as the animal source. As they evaporate, when they are exposed to air at ordinary temperature, they are also called as the ethereal oil. Then they represent the essence of the active constituents of the plant, hence they are also called as the essential oils. Chemically, they are derived from the terpenes and their oxygenated compounds, as already we have seen. They are made up of isoprene unit, that is, they are biosynthesized through the isoprenoid unit, and it consists of the long chain of C5H8, and usually they are called as monoterpenoids, sesquiterpenoids, diterpenes, with the empirical formula of C5H8, C10H16, C15H24, C20H32 respectively. So it is a long chain of the isoprene unit. Properties of volatile oil: solubility, they are soluble in alcohol, ether and other lipid solvents, and practically insoluble in water. Density, lighter than water except clove oil. This density, it is essential during the extraction of the volatile oil by means of the hydrodistillation method. So in this case, generally the volatile oils, they are the lighter than the water, means they will float above the water. The exception to this is the clove oil, which will sink. Odor, it is characteristic for that particular plant, it is characteristic. The odor of the clove is different, odor of tulsi is different, mentha is different. So odor is characteristic, and by that odor you can identify that particular plant. Refractive index is high, and most of them, they are the optically active. Secreted in a special structures such as ducts, cells in the plants, pseudogenous or lysogenous glands, and also in the trichomes. So they are secreted in the special structures, ducts, cells, or the pseudogenous or the lysogenous glands, or in the trichomes. Commonly found in the families such as Labiatae, Rutaceae, Piperaceae, Zenzibaraceae, Umbelliferae, Myrtaceae, and Lauraceae. Present in entire plant or in the particular part of the plants, they are present. So they may be saturated in the particular part of the plant, in the fruits or in the flower or in the stem or in the bark or in the leaf or in the wood. They may be saturated, or sometimes they are present in the whole plant also. Then we will see about the extraction of the volatile oil. Volatile oils, they are extracted by the hydrodistillation method. Next one, solvent extraction method. Third one is the Ecully method, and fourth one, effluorage technique. So the extraction of the volatile oil, it is done by these four techniques: hydrodistillation, solvent extraction, Ecully method, and effluorage method. So first of all, we will see about the hydrodistillation method. As the name indicates, hydro means water. In this case, the water is used for the purpose of distillation, so it is called as the hydrodistillation method. The hydrodistillation method is further classified as a water distillation method. In this case, the water is used for the distillation of the volatile oil, so it is called as the water distillation method. Next one, water and steam distillation method. In this case, the combination of the water as well as the steam, it is used for the extraction of the volatile oil, so it is called as the water and steam distillation. And third one, the steam distillation method. As the name indicates, the steam is used for the extraction of the volatile oil, so it is called as the steam distillation method. Use for the extraction of the volatile oil from herbal drugs. The hydrodistillation method, it is used for the extraction of the volatile oil from the herbal drugs. The fresh material is subjected to hydrodistillation in case of leaf drug. In case of the leaf drug, the fresh material is directly subjected for the extraction of the volatile oil by means of the hydrodistillation method. Air-dried subterranean parts are extracted by steam distillation method. If the part, it is air-dried, then the steam distillation method, it is used for the extraction. For the hydrodistillation method, that is, the by using the water,
The apparatus which is used, it is called as the Clavenger apparatus. It is called as the Clavenger apparatus. Here you can see that the two apparatus, one apparatus that is A, it is for oils lighter than the water, and B is for the oils heavier than the water. Lighter than the water and the heavier than the water. So, in case of the lighter than the water means having a low density, so it will float on the top of the water, and for the oils heavier than the water having a more density as compared to the water, so it will sink. So this Clavenger apparatus, it consists of this round bottom flask, then there is this side tube, then this is the condenser. These are the two joints for the condenser, for incoming of the water, for outgoing of the water. Then this is the graduated tube, this is the cock, and this is the return flow tube. This is called as the return flow tube. During the use of this Clavenger apparatus, you have to place the crude drug along with the water. That is, first of all you have to add the porcelain pieces, then you have to add the pieces of the crude drug from which you have to extract the volatile oil, and then you have to add the water. As it is the water distillation method, you have to add the water and start heating by directly burner, or you can use any another source such as the mantle for heating purpose. When the water will start boiling, the vapors of the water will generate, and the due to the high temperature of the water, then the volatile oil will also get extracted out from the crude drug, and the vapors of the water and the volatile oil will pass through this tube into the condenser. In condenser, both the volatile oil as well as the water, that is the vapors of the water, it will get condensed and it will fall into this graduated tube. As the volatile oil, it is lighter than the water, it will float into the graduated tube, and the excess of the water will again pass into the round bottom flask. So in this way, at last you have to continue this process for 3 hours. At last stop heating, count down the amount of the oil obtained by this graduated tube, that is either it is a 1 ml or 2 ml or 0.5 ml, and you can calculate the percentage of the volatile oil which is present in case of this drug. So in this way you can carry out the extraction of the volatile oil by using the Clavenger apparatus. In this case, in this next, so it is used for the heavier than the water, the process is same, but only in this case, as the volatile oil, it is the heavier than the water. When the vapors of the volatile oil as the and the water, it will condense, it will fall into this graduated tube. As the volatile oil is heavier than the water, it will sink at the bottom, and the excess of the water will pass through this tube, through this return flow tube, into the round bottom flask. So depending upon the volatile oil which is present in the crude drug, either having a lower density as compared to the water or higher density compared to the water, you have to choose the apparatus. The principle is same. So this is the Clavenger apparatus which is used for the extraction of the volatile oil from the plant or from the crude drug. Next is, this is the steam distillation method. So in this case, the steam, it is used for the extraction of the volatile oil. So in this way you can use the steel for the extraction. So this is the steel. A used steel is used for the extraction of the volatile oil by means of the steam distillation method. This is the perforated bottom. This is the perforated bottom. Below this perforated bottom, you have to place the water so that you can generate the steam from this water. This is the outlet. After completion of the process, you have to remove the crude drug. So from this outlet, you can remove the crude drug. This is the inlet. From here, you can add the crude drug, and that crude drug is placed on this perforated bottom. On this perforated bottom, here you have to place the water. Then there is this side tube, and here it is a condenser. This is the condenser, and it will go to the separator. So this is the inlet for the water. This is the outlet for the water. First of all, you have to place the water into this still. Then you have to place the drug and start heating the water. You have to heat the water. So the water will start boiling and the generation of steam will take place. When the steam will generate, it will pass through this false perforated bottom to the drug. And when it will pass through the drug, the volatile oil which is present in the crude drug, it will get extracted out, and the water vapor as well as the steam which is generated, it will pass through this tube to the condenser. In the condenser, both, that is the water vapor as well as the volatile oil, it will get condensed, and then it is provided to the separator. In the separator, depending upon the density, the separator is chosen depending upon the density of the volatile oil. The volatile oil will either float or it will sink. Depending upon that, the separator is to be used. So in this case, the steam, it is used for the extraction of the volatile oil. The crude drug does not come directly in contact with the water, but the steam is first generated and then it is passed through the crude drug, due to which the volatile oil will get extracted out, and the separation of the volatile oil is done by means of the steam distillation method. The volatile oil such as the Nilgiri oil, it is extracted by means of the steam distillation method. Next method, it is the enfourage method. In this case, this method it is used for the extraction of a delicated perfume from the flower petals such as rose. So used for the extraction of dedicated perfumes, fresh flower petals mechanically spread over the layer of the fatty material, that is the wax, allowed to imbibe, that is allowed to extract the volatile oil which is present in the petals. Then exhausted petals, they are replaced by fresh petals. The process is continued till the fatty material is saturated with the volatile principles. Then the wax, it is collected, extracted with the solvent, and the volatile oil is separated from the fat or from the wax. The remaining wax, after the extraction of the volatile oil, it is used as an pomade. So here you can see such type of the trays, they are used for the extraction of the volatile oil by means of the enfourage and deflourage method. Enfourage means placing the rose petals, and deflourage means the removing of the rose petals and placing the new petals. So in this case, the tray, number of the trays they are used for this purpose, these trays, they are coated, these trays, they are coated with the wax, and on these the rose petals they are placed. Then after 24 hours, the rose petals they are removed. So within these 24 hours, the volatile oil which is present in the rose petal, it will get extracted out into the wax. So in this way, the process is repeated till the wax will become saturated with the volatile oil. Then the wax is collected, the volatile oil which is present in the wax, it is separated out by means of the solvent extraction method, and the remaining wax after the extraction, it is used as a pomade. So this method, it is called as the enfleurage method or enfleurage or defleurage method. Then the next method, it is the Ecully method. It is called as the Ecully method. So in this case, used for the extraction of the citrus oil. Oil cells in the rind, they are ruptured mechanically using a pointed projections by twisting raw material over them in clockwise direction, either mechanically or manually. So in this case, the oil cells or the cells containing the oil, they are ruptured mechanically and the volatile oil is taken out. The volatile oil which ooze out, it is absorbed on the sponge. Then when the sponge will become saturated with the volatile oil, then again by means of the solvent extraction method, the volatile oil from the sponge is taken out. So in this case, this type is used in case of the lemon peel or in case of the orange peels. When we press the lemon peel or orange peel, the volatile oil comes out. The volatile oils comes out. So this volatile oil, it is absorbed on the sponge, and later on from the sponge, the extraction of the oil is done. This type of the method, it is called as the Ecully method. It is also called as the mechanical method, which is used for the extraction of volatile oil. Last one, that is the solvent extraction method. In this case, the solvents such as the benzene, alcohol, chloroform, they are used for the extraction of the volatile oil. The sophisticated perfumery industry utilize solvent extraction technique for the production of volatile oil using the solvent like ether or benzene, as it is quick, quality assured, and it is an economical method. So the sophisticated industries, they prefer the solvent extraction method for the extraction of the volatile oil. The deterioration of volatile oil is less as compared to hydrodistillation method. So when the volatile oil, it is obtained by means of the solvent extraction method, the deterioration is less. The deterioration is less because in case of the hydrodistillation method, some traces of water may remain into the volatile oil, which is caused the deterioration of the oil. In this case, as there is no use of the water, the deterioration of the volatile oil is less. The solvent distill off may be reused. So, and after the extraction using the solvent, you have to separate the volatile oil from the solvent by means of the distillation, and after the distillation, again the solvent is collected and it can be reused for the further extraction of the volatile oil. Then the volatile oils containing the drugs can be classified as an alcohol volatile oil. They are the peppermint, cardamom, coriander, orange flower, rose oil, sandal oil. Next one, aldehyde volatile oil, cinnamon, lemon or orange peel, citronella, lemongrass, bitter almond. Then ester volatile oil, gaultheria, lavender, mustard, hydrocarbons, turpentine, black pepper, ketone volatile oil, caraway, spearmint, buchu, camphor, musk, civet, oxide volatile oil, chinopodium, eucalyptus, phenolic ethers, anise, fennel, nutmeg, and phenol volatile oil. They are the clove, thyme, and cresol. So in this way, the volatile oil, they can be classified. Uses, use as an flavoring and perfuming agent in pharmaceutical formulations, foods, beverages, and cosmetic. They are used as an flavoring agent because of their aroma, because of their specific aroma. They are used as an flavoring agent in case of the food industries, in case of the pharmaceutical industries, and in case of the cosmetic industries.
as an perfuming agent in pharmaceutical formulations, food, beverages and cosmetics. Use as a medicinal agent such as carminative. It is used as a medicinal agent as an carminative, umbelliferous fruits, cinnamon and antihelminthics, that is the chinopodium. It is used as a diuretic, as a juniper. It is used as an antiseptic, eucalyptus. It is used as a counter irritant, that is the example is oil of wintergreen. It is used as a local anesthetic, that is the clove. It is used as a sedative, that is jetmansi. It is used as a local irritant, chawal mogra oil. So they are used therapeutically for the different purpose. They are used therapeutically as a carminative, antihelminthic, diuretic, antiseptic, counter irritant, local anesthetic, sedative and local irritant, and for the different purpose it is used. Citronella oil, it is used as an insect repellent. It is used in case of the mosquito repellent coils, then liquids, as well as it is used in case of the floor cleaners. Lemongrass oil, it is used for the citral content and subsequently for the synthesis of vitamin A. Lemongrass oil, which is obtained from the lemongrass, it is used for the citral content and subsequently for the synthesis of the vitamin A. Terpeneless oils, they are valuable perfuming and flavoring agents. Nowadays, the terpeneless, that is the terpenes, are separated from the volatile oil and they are used in the cosmetic industry because the flavoring capacity of the volatile oil, it increases many folds. So in this way, the volatile oils, they are used for the different purposes in case of the food industries, in case of the pharmaceutical industries, for the therapeutic purpose, as well as pharmaceutically it is used as a flavoring agent. It is used in case of the beverages and also it is widely used in case of the cosmetics. Then as the terpeneless volatile oil, it is the volatile oil which is more preferred by the sophisticated cosmetic industries, more important in perfumery industries because of their specificity and stability. They are processed by removing the hydrocarbons and undesired components by fractional distillation and other techniques, such as the usually kept as guarded secrets by the manufacturer. So in this case, the terpenes, they are removed. So the process by removing hydrocarbons and undesirable components by fractional distillation and other techniques, which is usually kept as a guard secret by the manufacturer, and these terpeneless volatile oils, they are prepared. They are used in manufacture of high-priced cosmetic and perfumes. So they are used for the manufacturing of high-priced cosmetics and perfumes. So terpeneless volatile oil, it is costlier as compared to our simple volatile oil. Chemical test for the identification of the volatile oil. Thin section of the drug is taken. Alkylic solution of Sudan red is added red color to the globules. It will indicate the presence of the volatile oil. The thin section is taken, to it added alkylic solution of Sudan red 3 red color. Globules will develop. It will indicate the presence of volatile oil. Next test, to the thin section of the drug, a drop of tincture of alkana is added. Red color will indicate the presence of volatile oil. Then the storage of volatile oil. The certain volatile oils are liable to deteriorate on chipping. So the special precautions should be taken during the storage of the volatile oil for the long term. The deterioration is accompanied by change in color or increase in viscosity of the oil or change in the odor of the oil. Preserved properly in well-closed container, in cool and dry place, and the container should be well filled. That is, the container should be totally filled so that the oxygen will not remain and deterioration will not take place of the volatile oil. So preserved properly in well-closed, well-filled containers away from light and cool place. So this is all about the volatile oils. Thank you very much. If you like this video, click on like, subscribe the channel, and also click on the bell icon so that you can know the new video published. Thank you very much once again.